Hello and welcome to Nature's Finest Discovery Channel with me, Kim. Today's show, we're going to be taking you down to the local coast of Haysborough, otherwise known as Happysburg by Mr. Friel. Now those of you who go to the beach quite often will know that on days like today, it's cold and windy. But rest assured, I am prepared, for today I have brought along my yellow Mac. I am prepared for any storm that could possibly come this way and crumble this cliff like there's no tomorrow. Except this one! Now to many of you, this may not seem like a complete masterpiece, but in fact it is. This standard piece of rock was once a very tall cliff which has been eroded over time. Now there are four main types of erosion. There are hydraulic action, abrasion or corrosion, attrition or solution. Today on the show with us we have major rock expert Geoffrey Hughes from King's Lynn. He's going to tell us today what sort of erosion he thinks affected this cliff as it once was and reasons for his opinion. So Geoffrey, what kind of erosion do you think has affected this cliff then?
I think abrasion or corrosion has affected this cliff.
And could you explain to our viewers what that means?
Well, it means parts of a rock fragment have been taken away by the tide and constantly thrown up against the cliff behind us, you see, eventually forcing it to fall down.
So, roughly, how long would you say it takes for a cliff to be completely eroded?
I think for at least, it goes a cubic metre per year.
It's quite a lot if you think about it, isn't it?
Yes.
And can't we do anything to prevent this?
We can actually. We can build things like sea walls.
And are they pricey or are they cheap?
They're not cheap, I'll tell you that. You can get them for £3,000 to £5,000 for per cubic metre.
Jeez, do you think that's maybe why this cliff was affected by erosion? Do you think they didn't build any sea defences, maybe?
Yeah, I don't think that they could afford this because this is not a tourist attraction place like Constantine is. But I think people will be quite depressed to see like this sea shop to be fallen down in a couple of years' time by sea.
Thank you for being on the show with us today, Geoffrey. It's much appreciated.
No
problem at all. Now if you'd like to move up with me to this tea shop, the local tea shop in Haysborough, we're going to talk to the owner and see her views and opinions on where she thinks the tea shop's going to go. Will it fall in the sea or will it be bulldozed? Let's go and find out. If you'd like to follow me into the local tea shop of Haysborough. So I take it you know about the coastal erosion in Haysborough. Are you scared of the fate of your tea shop?
Of course, this tea shop's been here for over 10 years. You know, I provide a valuable service.
And you realise the fact that sooner or later your tea shop may either fall into the sea or be bulldozed?
Of course. We've heard all about coastal erosion on the news, etc, etc. I've been in touch with the government. They really don't seem to be willing to do anything. It's like the little people don't matter.
And have you tried to prevent this in any way?
Yeah, we've petitioned the government to get new sea defences built because the sea defences that are here are very, very old and they're crumbling. But again, the government just don't have the resources to build the sea defences. They're not willing to build the sea defences. What can we do?
I'll hunt Mr. Friel!
Cliffs all over the coast are being eroded slowly over time. If you feel that this is an issue and want to do something about it, look on the site www.discoverychannel/naturesfinest or send an email to seadefences@government.co.uk. And if you don't know what I just said, here's the link. Unfortunately, that concludes today's show. But join us next time where we'll be taking you to the magical land of Africa. See you next time. I could crumble this cliff like there's no tomorrow.
Except this one. Okay, you can stop it now. You can stop it now! I'm wet!
Running!
Of Haysborough. Out. Oh, just carry
on. Slugs! I'm not sitting on slugs. So, is that costly or is it cheap?
I tell you, Kim, it's not cheap. It's quite pricey, actually. You could get them for £3,000 out to £5,000. This plant is very scratchy on your backside.
Oh, we'll have to reshot that, Hannah.
God.
It really hurts. Is in some deal of pain right now. This plant is hurting her bum.
Unfortunately, that concludes today's show. Where next time... That plane's too noisy.
Green scarf.
Goodbye.